and welcome to another exciting edition of the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast. I am your MC, Davo. With me today, we have Kells.
Hello there.
We have Twy.
It's-a me.
We have Andy.
Hello, Ladle Brainers.
We have the Sensei, Neil.
Hey, everybody. Let's play a game of trivia.
Oh, I gave my left field.
Sure, so, I've got nothing else to do.
Good. I'm glad you all have some time. It's convenient. So each week we have a theme. Within that theme, we've got six categories, four questions each. Each question is worth 10 points with a few bonus points thrown in here and there in the final, which is worth up to 100 points. So we're about to start game five of our
high karate
tournament.
So good.
It is so good.
The way we score the tournament, first place gets you 4 points, second place gets you 3 points, and so on. And after four games, our scores are, you know, on my tournament scoring spreadsheet here, I was doing some like what if analysis to help Davo figure out if Kells has locked it in the tournament already. There are scenarios. There's at least one scenario where Kells loses the tournament and everybody else beats him, and even Davo wins the tournament.
Wow. Mm-hmm. What's gonna happen?
So
is there a scenario where monkeys fly out of my butt too?
So for that to happen, Kells would have to come in fourth in the next four games.
Yeah, okay. Yep. That's not happening.
And Davo would have to at least win two and come in second twice.
So it's not impossible, but improbable.
I've got here a score sheet where Kells ends up with 19 total tournament points. Twy and Andy have 20, and Davo has 21. Ooh. So mm-hmm. It's conceivable.
It's out there.
He Dr. Stranged it with the time stone, and I am the 14 millionth one.
Yeah.
But as it actually stands right now after game four, Davo has 7 points, Andy Ooh. 8, Twy 10, and Kells has 15 points.
Okay. Everybody, we know what we have to do tonight.
Karate chop please, Kells in the face.
Please yep. don't.
Yep. Why is everything in the face? Why can't we just chop him? Do we have nice. To nothing his beautiful
face? You're such
face?
A girl. You're such a girl.
Everything's in the face. Lightning bolt yeah. to the face. Lightning bolt right. to the face. Right.
So's your face. So speaking of the karate chop, the way the gimmick for this tournament works is each player has one opportunity to chop another player. If that player gets the question correct, the chopper gets those points. The choppy gets nothing. But if the choppy gets it wrong, then the chopper loses their opportunity to answer the next question, because with the
high karate, be careful how you use it.
You gotta be careful how you use it. Never. That's just genuinely as funny as the first time I heard it.
I don't want this tournament to end.
I could keep playing the clips.
Oh, good.
I probably will, to be honest, because you know how I am with those things. I have. So today's tournament, or today's show, I mean, came courtesy of one of our listeners, Gina, who sent it out of the blue.
Gina?
Yeah, she wrote a quiz for us a long, long, long time ago. I forget which one that was. I should have looked that up.
I remember that show.
Yeah, so she wrote back and said, hey, I just thought I'd do another one. And I thought that was great.
Thank you, Gina.
So thank you, Gina K.
Thank you.
And this quiz is all about punctuation.
Oh, no.
Boy.
So I thought that was a great theme for a quiz. And going through it the first couple times, I thought it was great. But then I something clicked with me. Some of these aren't punctuation per se, as in grammar pieces of grammar. They're special characters, right? So, like, there may be occasionally there's going to be like maybe a mathematical thing or an accent on a character, that sort of thing. So, just letting you know that it's not necessarily all punctuation.
Cool. Okay.
But most of them are. Okay.
Right.
Yeah. All right. So, category one is science.
God bless. Beth.
Science, punctuation.
The first category.
Okay. Question one. A factorial is a mathematical operation that takes any whole number and multiplies it by every lesser whole number. In computer science, the most common application for factorials is figuring out how many ways you can arrange multiple items, so basically combinations. What expressive punctuation marks a factorial? So think back to your high school math classes.
No.
But they didn't really have math when Andy was in high school.
Yeah. They did, but they didn't have all those numbers. A lot of those are recent.
Yeah, I don't think factorial exists in like Roman numerals. Kind of like zero.
I am locked in while he's being a dick. I am getting better at just pushing away the rudeness and focusing. I am focused up tonight.
Locked in?
I'm locked in.
In case anybody corrects me, factorials used for combinations and permutations.
Oh, I was thinking that. That was why I was struggling so much.
Right. I didn't want to leave that out.
I'm like,
this is going to be magical.
We'll start with Kels.
Exclamation point.
Deva.
Parentheses.
Andy?
You said expressive, so I'm guessing the exclamation point.
Twy?
Exclamation point?
The correct answer is the exclamation point.
Fart. I was thinking that, and I should have gone with my first instinct. But then I thought of emojis having their little expressions, that like emoticons.
Question two. O negative is a universal blood... is the universal blood donor, and AB plus is the universal recipient. What does the positive or negative indicator of a person's blood type symbolize? And for a bonus, what is the most common blood type? And for a double bonus, what is the least common?
I feel comfortable with only one part of this question.
I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Yeah, why not? I'm locked in.
Deva?
I'm locked in.
Okay, tell me your answer.
Okay. I believe it's Rh factor. And the most common is O positive, and the least common is AB negative.
Okay, Andy?
I have Rh as well, and I also have O positive as the most common. I have A positive, so I know it's not that for the least common. I'm going to go with Z minus.
Oh, that's a bold choice.
I've never heard of it before, so it's got to be pretty rare.
Yeah, by that logic, that's probably true.
Thank you.
Twy?
Rh factor, and most common is O positive, which is mine, and AB negative is least common.
And Kels?
Rhesus factor. O positive, AB negative.
All right. Well, most of you got all of it right. Andy, you missed the least common. It is the Rh factor or protein or the rhesus factor. Most common is O positive and least is AB minus, AB negative. Question three, what punctuation mark is used to denote the derivative function in calculus?
I was promised there'd be no math.
Nope, you were not.
Punctuation mark, let's say Don't even know.
Locked in.
I'm locked in.
All the kids are doing it.
Locked in.
I am.
All the AP math kids are doing it.
Yeah, I don't hang with those kids. I'm locked in.
Okay, let's start with Andy.
Question mark. That's what I have for all of this. Just a big ass question mark.
Toy.
Wish I'd thought of that.
Kels.
If I remember correctly, like whenever we did derivative stuff, it was a lowercase f parentheses x. So I put parentheses.
Holy crap.
That's a function. Oh.
Deva.
I said parentheses because I love parentheses.
You sound so happy, Devo.
What?
It's wrong.
Yay!
So f parentheses x is you would refer to that as the function of x or f of x.
Right.
The derivative of that is f prime of x, and the prime is denoted by an apostrophe.
I see it now.
Yikes.
I didn't remember if that was right or not.
Yeah, no kidding.
Kels, I honestly thought that you were sandbagging on that one.
No, it's been a while. And then, you know, it's just trauma, so I don't like digging it back up.
That's like the only thing I remember from calculus. Question 4. According to the BIPM, which is an organization that defines the SI units in the UTC timescale.
Wow, some, I'm already lost.
It's some French name. Mm-hmm. But according to them, what punctuation marks are acceptable for decimal marks in English and French versions, respectively? And for bonus, what is the only character that's acceptable for separating groups of three numbers, or what you might call the thousands separator?
I'm locked in and I'm convinced this is a trap.
Okay. I've got punctuation marks aplenty written down on my paper. Mm-hmm.
And I just want to be clear that this is a question I added in here. So don't blame Gina for this one.
I'm not blaming Gina for nothing now.
Yeah,
I was about to. Sure. He's going to fire off an angry email. But now I know who to blame.
The BIPM.
Those bastards.
They're French.
I have no problem with that.
Andy does.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's start with Twy.
A period and a comma. I have no idea about the bonus.
Okay. Kels, go ahead.
A period and a comma.
No bonus?
No, sir. No, I did not.
David?
What am I missing?
Period and comma.
Okay. And Andy.
The English is a period. The French is a comma. And I thought a comma also separated out the thousands.
Okay. Well, I'm glad, Andy, you're the only one that even tried to answer that part. It wasn't right, but.
Is it a space? I have a parenthetical. It's a space.
It is a space. Yeah.
Damn it. I was torn, but I thought you were showing. Okay. I was trying to think of another myself.
Punctuation. Me too.
To go there.
Because like, to me, a space is not punctuation.
Well, I didn't say, I said character. I didn't say punctuation.
It's not a character either.
It is too.
It's the Holy Ghost of writing.
It's the zero of writing.
Well, you can't do math without zero, and you can't write without spaces.
It counts on your character limit and when you write a tweet.
This is true.
Or an X, whatever the hell they call it now.
Twix.
At the end of category one, I was going to say a painful category one, but actually the scores are pretty good. Devo has 30, Andy 35, Kels 40, and Twy 50.
Woo!
Wow.
Big money.
I felt good with my 30. Holy crap.
Well, it's time for category two.
Greetings, meat bags. This is Lyric Bot 5000. You may refer to me as LB5K if your puny human brains do not have the capacity to remember my name. Name the songs that I will sing to you.
Hell yeah, I will.
So these are all going to be songs that have some parenthetical part of the title.
Oh,
even better.
Better. So okay. I was kind of debating on how to score this. I don't think I'm going to make you tell me where the parentheses are exactly. You can if you want to try it, but if you get it wrong, it'll be wrong. So if you don't try it, you still have to tell me all of the words in the title, including the parentheticals.
Oh, God. Okay.
I might be a little bit lenient if you miss one or two words here, but you've got to get the gist of it.
Okay.
Question one. You missed two classes and no homework, but your teacher preaches class like you are some kind of jerk.
What am I missing? Oh, right. Locked in.
I thought you figured out what you were missing. That's the first one. Locked in.
Locked in.
All right. Let's start with Devo.
Fight for your right to party.
Okay. Andy?
Parentheses, you gotta, and parentheses.
Son of a
fight for your right.
God, no.
The distance frustration is also funny.
I know. He's in the neighbor's house right now. That's how mad he is. You can still hear him.
Okay, Twy.
You gotta, in parentheses, fight for your right.
Okay, Kels.
Parentheses, you gotta, close parentheses, fight for your right.
Devo didn't have any punctuation in his answer.
I said that was optional, and then if you got it wrong, you get the question wrong. It's kind of like a last name thing.
Mm.
So he's actually playing it safe.
Except he got a lot of the words wrong.
Well, here's the thing. None of you got it right. I'm just trying to decide how long the score is. None of us got it
right. What do you mean?
You all got the song right, so I'll give you all 7 points just to be
fun. Are we supposed to have the artist too?
No. The correct answer is you gotta, in parentheses, fight for your right, and then in parentheses, two party.
Fuzz extra.
Oh, two party. I didn't know two party was in parentheses.
So Devo missed the you gotta. The rest of you all missed the two party.
Oh, look at that.
But
so I think there might be an apology in line for Devo.
No, I apologize. You're right. I did not have that song title correct.
Thank you. By the way.
You gotta fight for your right to party.
I miss the Beastie Boys.
That feels tricksy to start us off with a double parenthetical.
Double parenthetical.
No, I think that was
God agrees.
Wasn't it Run DMC that was tricky?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Very, very. And Gollum was tricksy.
Okay, so I gave you all 7 points for that one because y'all obviously knew
fair.
It.
That's fair.
Question two. Pull me into your arms. Say I'm the one you own. If you don't, you'll be alone, and like a ghost, I'll be gone.
God bless.
This is familiar.
Right?
I just got to get the melody.
You couldn't from that beautiful vocal performance?
You've all heard this song before.
I'm sure.
I guarantee it.
I am walking in with a police song.
That's on the bingo card.
Yeah. I don't got this.
I just made my ex a factorial.
Oh, and it sounds really familiar. Oh, wait a minute. I'm locked in. Now I got it. I was going the wrong direction with it for a while, I think.
Okay. Then let's start with Twy.
Single ladies in parentheses put a ring on it.
Kels.
Single ladies in parentheses put a ring on it.
Deva.
I'll be in parentheses wrapped around your finger.
I mean, sort of. Andy?
Single ladies, parentheses, put a ring on it.
I don't think I've ever heard this entire song. In fact, I've never heard this entire song. I just hear the put a ring. I just hear the on it, on it, on it. That's all I've ever heard of this song.
I tried to find a tricky part.
But it took me a minute to get. Yeah, I was like, yeah, I know this. You succeeded.
But David, the only part I could have put that you would have gotten was the actual name of the song.
That's your problem, not mine.
Well, I mean, it's kind of your problem.
That's kind of your problem.
Just put the
part. Just have him go, I would have gotten it.
Question 3. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, but you're the key to my peace of mind.
Oh.
Locked in.
Someone's begging for a karate chop to the face.
I believe so, buddy.
Wait, now I want to sing it. Hold on.
Yeah,
sing it. No, don't you mute yourself. Why? How dare you?
Writing stuff down.
Okay, I got it out.
Did you just mute and sing it?
Yes. Landed. That was some emotion on that one.
It was gonna be stuck in my head.
This is the kind of title you can't just say, you have to sing it.
I'm like that.
With all the feeling.
David, did all you right. put your police song yet?
No, I'm trying a different song.
Different band or just a different police song?
Kind of branching out.
I'm branching out.
I didn't know you knew any Rihanna songs.
If it's Rihanna, I'm going to be pissed. I'm
locked in. I don't actually know any Rihanna songs.
I know Umbrella, Ella, Ella, Ella.
No parentheses.
And Diamonds. And Diamonds, right? Diamonds? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, that's two.
Holy crap. Okay.
Getting salty.
Let's start with Kels.
In parentheses, you make me feel like a natural woman.
Nope, that's not what I said.
Nope. Shocked.
No. I know.
Shocked.
I said, I will always love you.
Oh, okay.
Aw. Parentheses, you make me feel like, in parentheses, a natural woman.
I think I've heard this song like 30,000 times. My mom loved this song. Oh, this Carole King.
Aretha Franklin. Come on.
Oh, never mind. Twice. And I probably haven't heard it 30,000 times.
In parentheses, you make me feel like a natural woman. Before
the day I met you. I think I've heard this song once or twice. You're the key to my peace of mind. You make me feel. You make me feel. Why is this used in a commercial?
Was it deodorant commercial?
Yeah, I think it was a deodorant commercial.
Yeah, I think it was.
Yeah.
Was it the Secret of Dove?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't care what you guys say. I think Aretha was a good singer.
Hot take from the Sensei. Way to go on that one.
Way to live on that island by yourself, man.
Question 4. Now he's getting a tattoo. Yeah, he's getting ink done. He asked for a 13, but they drew a 31.
Wait, what?
Locked in.
What if three people karate chop the same person all at once?
then you all win if they get it right.
Okay.
But in a sense, does anybody really win?
You know,
the person getting chopped.
The listeners are in.
I don't know this at all.
Everybody needs to think about it. I'll help. You need to think about this because you do know this.
You think I know this for real, Andy?
Yes, for real.
Where would I have heard this song, Andy?
Yeah.
MTV.
I am not watching MTV like
this
that.
This song is one of those songs that you did not escape.
Home it for us.
Can you sing a few bars?
I'm locked in.
We're going to start with Kels.
I'm sorry, but I am karate chopping Andy.
Chop a bob, baby.
Oh. Deva?
Pretty fly, in parentheses, for a white guy.
Never heard this.
Yes, you have.
Give it to me, baby.
Andy?
I'm not sorry. I'm chopping Andy.
Son of a...
Oh, look at that. It's a me, yeah.
Wow.
I was thinking that one person lies because I always hear the chop a bop.
It's because I care about you guys.
I appreciate it, man. Appreciate now he's it. Sorry. A tattoo, yeah, he's getting ink done. He asked for a 13, but they drew a 31. Friends say he's trying too hard, and he's not quite hip. But in his own mind, he's the dumbest trap. I've never heard this song.
I don't think I've heard that either.
Wow, it really surprises me.
Weird Al did a version called Pretty Fly for a Rabbi.
Yeah.
That I am. The title I'm very familiar with.
I have been karate chopped twice.
Yep. That means
you're
just going
to let it go. I'm just going to say to myself, this is the business we've chosen.
Yep.
I didn't ask who gave the order. It's nothing to do with business.
Wait, the salty count on the bingo card if it's Andy and not Davo?
No, it's only Davo.
But you know what does count?
This is the business we've chosen.
It's so whimsical.
All right. At the end of category two, Andy has Davo has 47. Andy has 62. Kel's 77. Twy has 87.
Why am I even f-ing here?
Wow.
Oh, man.
Man,
what the hell?
Category three.
That's getting marked off my bingo card. Salty Davo, yep. Okay.
The saltiest Davo, maybe.
And I really am playing bingo. I'm test playing this card.
Oh, wow.
Even better.
All right, category three. This category is called Movies and TV Shows in the Style of Neil.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Oh, God.
So it seems like when Gina was writing these, she got a little sleepy sometimes.
I love
that. Happens.
So question one, again, this is her writing, so it's mm-hmm. from her perspective. Mm-hmm. Okay. I was watching the sci-fi series rerun where MacGyver kept going into this pool of water. I don't know how it didn't spill, though, because the pool was on its side. And for a bonus, I dozed off and woke up to what I thought was Aquaman, but the pool was there again, and Aquaman didn't have as many tattoos. It must have been an old episode of a spinoff or something.
I'm locked in and locked in. She has the same kind of TV apnea problem you do, man.
Yeah,
that's rough.
She does.
I know what the first one is, but the second one.
Man, I got the salty song playing in my head.
I guess I don't understand the question.
You're welcome, pals.
It's just so delightful.
Salty.
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
All right, let's start with Andy.
Stargate and Stargate Atlantis.
Twy.
Heroes and I don't know the bonus.
Kels.
Stargate SG-1 and Stargate Atlantis.
Deva.
Stargate SG-1 and Stargate Atlantis.
Andy, I can only give you credit for the bonus.
Damn it.
Because it is
SG. I forgot it was called Stargate SG-1.
SG-1 is where the punctuation part comes in.
Right.
And so does Stargate : Atlantis.
I have never watched that. Okay.
I haven't either.
Nor have I.
Question two. The premise of this film franchise was so disgusting, I didn't even bother to watch it long enough to get distracted. What horror trilogy strung together its titles with the parentheticals, parentheses first sequence, parentheses full sequence, and parentheses final sequence?
Locked in.
That is those.
That is those. You are correct.
Those are they.
I didn't realize they made that many.
Yes, they did.
I got no idea what this is.
Those are they.
Locked in.
Devo clearly knows about this from the get-go, which tells me this is something disturbing.
You're not wrong, my man. I
locked have in. No idea. I am going to punt.
I'm also locked in.
Okay. Start with Twy.
Final Destination.
Okay. Kels.
Human Centipede.
Devo.
The Human Centipede.
Andy.
Now Ray Guy comes in for his first punt of the day. Kick is away. There's a high twisting hang time spiral.
The correct answer is The Human Centipede. All right. So moving on. Question three. I thought I was watching Crazy Rich Asians, but then the mother started doing some Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon moves. And then the funny friend wasn't blonde anymore, and she seemed to think she was Hawkeye or something.
I thought you were watching Crazy Rich Asians.
What? But then the mom and the friend wasn't blonde anymore, but Hawkeye?
What?
Hawkeye from MASH or Hawkeye from the Avengers? That can go either way.
Right. Okay, you know, it could also be Hawkeye from the last of the Mohicans.
Right.
Oh.
There's so many Hawkeyes.
Locked in?
I have a guess. I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
I'm punting.
We're going to start with Deva.
We karate chopped Kells.
Good luck.
I didn't know. I take a shot.
Andy?
This one took me a while to figure out, and what she's talking about is actually not a very well known Quentin Tarantino film. It's called Kill Bill, and it's Kill Bill ? Kill Bill?
You know, it's always easy when you start some of your explanations to know when I can just put a zero in the column.
Yeah. I want to help you out there.
Twy.
Now Ray Guy comes in for his first punt of the day. Kick is away. There's a high twisting.
So the real question here: did Kells get it?
I don't know. Let's find out.
I put Shang-Chi in the Legend of the Ten Rings.
Oh,
Kells did get it.
Damn, I've seen that movie too.
And get no credit for it. So.
None whatsoever.
Oh, of course she was in Crazy. Oh.
So Aquafina was in Crazy Rich Asians.
Yep.
Oh,
shoot. Nice.
Good job, Devo.
Thank you.
Way to stick the landing on that one.
Did you play my clip?
Oh my God, how could I forget that? That's the best one.
Karate chop.
All right, question four. I was watching this comedy series with this tall guy and a bald guy that did a lot of skits together. Oh, and the season two winner of The Masked Singer was there and was pretty good at making up songs. This must have been a rerun, though, because the host of the episode is off doing some game show now.
Oh, locked my in. God.
Wow. I mean, there's a lot of information in there.
I was about to say it was an info dump.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Punt.
All right. Andy?
I don't know if it has punctuation. I'm hoping there's an exclamation mark in the movie title. Nope.
Okay.
I'm thinking the Key and Peele, and there's a game show guy in there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
No, that's a good guess.
But I don't know about the punctuation.
Nope. There is no punctuation.
Damn!
I'll answer your answer with an answer.
Oh.
Whose line is it anyway? Question mark.
Kels.
Whose line is it anyway?
Oh, I forgot it could be a TV show. Son of a mother.
Okay, that's clearly then I forgot the theme.
Yes. I forgot.
Forgot the category.
Forgot the category. Could be TV or movies.
I know the reason I won. I figured out who it was because I know Wayne Brady won season 2 of this Masked Singer.
I was stuck on the game show part because Wayne Brady and Drew Carey host game shows.
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. So at the end of category 3,
I didn't get a punt dance. It's like, why again? Wow. Why am I?
Because not everybody can win, Davo.
So I apologize. Here you go.
Now Ray Guy comes in for his first punt of the day. Kick is away. There's a high twisting hang time spiral.
Wow.
I'm also going to give you one of these.
Now here's the way you dance to the dog.
So at the end of category 3, Andy has 67 points, Devo has 82, Twy 97, and Kels 112.
So I'm ahead of Andy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And Kels is...
But that doesn't count for us anymore, man. Just enjoy it back here.
Kels is 2 points away from lapping me.
Yeah.
All right. Category 4 is historical possessives.
Okay. I was excited for a minute.
So just for explanation... Mm-hmm. These answers will all be in the style of someone's something. For example, if the question was about Alaska, the answer would be
Seward's Folly.
Oh, I see you're going with this.
Yeah. All right. So, okay. Here's the audio clip for question 1. And you just tell me what this piece of music is.
Okay. Oh, what number?
Locked in.
I might get this because of disco.
Locked in.
Okay, let's start with Twy.
Sound of the Times, Volume 1, by Prince.
Wow.
It's classical music.
Andy.
Beethoven's 5th.
Deva.
Beethoven's 5th.
And Kels.
Beethoven's 5th.
It is Beethoven's 5th. Da-da-da-da. So, Andy, what play did you go see a few days ago?
6.
Ah, that's what I thought. Okay, question 2.
Oh,
Anne Boleyn.
Locked in.
I'm just going to put this down just for grins and giggles. Locked in.
Locked in.
Start with Andy.
King Henry VIII's 2nd wife.
Oh, yes.
Deva?
King Henry VIII's 2nd wife.
Kels?
Henry VIII's 2nd wife.
And Twy?
2nd wife of Henry VIII.
Oh, Twy.
Yeah, I don't know what you're going to do with that.
It's possessive, but without
she forgot the theme. How does it feel?
It's a possessive statement.
Well, yeah.
Is that what
Twy, I'm not going to be able to give you the points for that one. Because I specifically said, we'll all be in the style of someone's something.
I know. I wrote it.
I like how he apologizes to you.
Well, no, I feel bad when someone clearly knows the answer, but there's a... Well, no, I don't always feel bad.
I don't feel bad. It's fine.
I'm thinking back to the Jeopardy episodes. And yeah.
You guys so enjoyed those Jeopardy episodes. They're not. They're not funny.
So I also would have accepted Elizabeth the First's mother.
Oh, I wondered what the... Of course.
Question three. An armed conflict between an alliance of the Lakota, Northern Cheyenne, and Northern Arapaho peoples against the United States and the Crow Nation that took place in Wyoming and Montana territories from 1866 to 1868. And I have an easy mode if you need it for half points.
I'm locked in.
Okay, let's start with Devo.
Custer's last stand.
Oh, nobody wanted the easy mode. Sorry.
Oh, damn. I should have taken that.
Yeah, sorry. The easy mode was picture a battle fought under a crimson sky. So Devo said whatever.
Custer's last stand.
Yeah. Kels.
Say King Philip's War.
Twy.
Red Cloud's War.
And Andy.
I love King Philip's War. That was much earlier. Red Cloud's War.
Correct answer is Red Cloud's War.
Man, I'm telling you, researching these strange and interesting facts for social media helps me learn a whole lot.
And our final question. Taken without consent, they have had an immortal impact on medical science and bioethics.
Taken with
plural.
I know what it is, but how do I tell you? Okay, wait.
It's somebody something.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about too. Darn it.
Locked
We've
in.
Had this before. It's in the podcast that you and I both listen to. What is that name? Locked in, I think. I
got nothing.
Same.
I'm not using the first name because I'm not positive about it. But
making something up. I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
Okay. So let's start with Kels.
Kevorkian Services.
Wow.
Whoa.
Twy.
Henrietta Lacks Cells.
Andy?
Oh.
I couldn't come up with Henrietta to save my life. I have lax cells.
Devo?
I have Smith's cells because I couldn't think of a name.
Well, it's too bad you couldn't think of a name because if you'd said lax, it would have been correct.
Mm-hmm.
It's Henrietta Lacks Cancer Cells. All right. So at the end of category four, let's see, we've got Deva with 102, Andy 107, Twy 117, and Kels 132.
Oh, okay. This has been a seesaw kind of match.
Category five is geography.
Oh, hell.
And then in parentheses, and foreign language.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Gosh, this is fun.
Okay, question one. Only three countries on the United Nations official list of member states contain an apostrophe. Name three of those countries. Name those three countries for 5 points each.
Oh, God.
Now I'm just going to write down countries that I can think of. It's going to be a very short list. So I can only think of one.
Well, okay, now Chad doesn't have any punctuation.
You only know
sort of eliminated Chad,
the English name, Andy.
Right, right.
Are you going to go through each one that you eliminate, or just the ones?
Yeah, pretty much. All I have is Chad. That's how bad I am with geography. Just have Chad.
And I can't forget South Chad.
I can't.
No, that doesn't have one either.
I can't come up with one.
I got one. I'm locked in.
You call him the fight, Dave.
Pretty much, man.
I feel like Dave has kind of lost the will to live.
Yeah. Dave was not having fun anymore.
Don't go pat mail on me, Dave. Hang on.
I got one, and I got it thanks to Dave.
How is that even possible?
I know what this one is.
Well, it's not Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Bangladesh.
I'm locking in with the two I got. Because I cannot think of a third one. Kels, I can't believe you can't think of one.
No, I got one. I'm just...
I mean, the other two.
Yeah. But in an effort to save time, I'm just going to lock in with my one.
Okay. So let's start with Davo.
I just put Thailand because I know they have a very long, real official name.
Ooh.
Kels?
I think I just thought of another one, but I only have Cote d'Ivoire.
Okay. Cote d'Ivory.
Oh my God. Put that on the card because that hurts me every time.
I was kind of hoping that David was going to answer, but just say the Ivory Coast. Twy.
Cote d'Ivoire and Democratic People's Republic of Korea.
Ooh. Nice.
Andy.
Cote d'Ivory is the only one I got, thanks to Dave.
How do you butcher it so badly?
Dave, how do you pronounce it?
Cote d'Ivory.
See, I did not mispronounce anything.
So
the pronunciation was spot on.
The answers are Cote d'Ivoire, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea.
Very nice.
And the Lao People's Democratic Republic.
Wow. Oh, that's right.
I might have gotten the Korea one if I had all day. I would have never gotten that last one. I'm fine with Cote d'Ivory.
Did you know that was a country? Laos?
Did I?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I knew, but okay. I didn't know it was
I didn't know its full name. Yeah, I didn't know its full
name. I didn't know the full name either.
Yeah. He hadn't been properly introduced.
I just knew him as Chad.
Question two. In May 2022, the Turkish government requested that the United Nations replace the English spelling of their country with the Turkish spelling. So how does this new spelling make it unique among the UN's official list of member states? So it helps if you know what the new spelling is.
I can kind of visualize it.
Yeah, me too.
I can't. Okay. I think I know what this is asking. I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
Start with Kels.
It has umlauts.
Yes.
Twy.
It has umlauts.
Andy.
Umlauts.
And Eva.
Umlaut.
Is the only country with an umlaut. Question three. The native language of Hawaii contains just 13 letters, the five vowels, seven traditional consonants, and the okina, which is represented by a reverse apostrophe. Its sound is defined as an obstruction of air in the vocal tract and can be described as a kind of catch in the throat. What is the linguistic term for the sound of an okina, that the sound an okina represents?
So, essentially, it sounds like Darth Vader all the time? When you pronounce a word that's in there, or you just notes and ideas? I mean, how does that work?
Not precisely, but... I'm locked in.
I'm going to punt.
Wow. Rare Kels punt.
The rare Kels punt.
I think it's justified this time.
Oh, I got nothing. I've already punted.
Hawaii.
I'm locked in.
Locked in.
We'll start with Twy.
It's a stop, but I forgot what it's called. It's some type of stop.
Andy?
A Buddy Holly hiccup.
Yeah. Kind of, yeah. Deva?
That's all I got.
A glottal stop?
Yes!
What?
And Kells.
Now Ray Guy comes in for his first punt of the day. Kick is away. There's a high twisting hang time spiral.
The correct answer is glottal stop.
Glottal stop. Ooh, Deva.
Thank you.
So, Twy, I'll give you half points because it is a stop. The glottal refers to, the part of your throat where you make that stop.
The glottis.
So, she included a trivia nugget that says the okina is considered the eighth consonant in the Hawaiian alphabet. And she says the Cockney accent is a great example of the glottal stop. If you say butter like butter, you pretty much got it. Oh boy! Oh my god!
Yeah,
nailed it! Nailed
wow.
it!
Wow!
Damn right I did.
It's the Muppet again.
I thought we were watching Peaky Blinders for a second.
Transforms you.
I'm not dead.
It's been a year. You're dead. Let's move on.
I think me death like Elvis.
Your bad ear son has taken over, so just deal with it.
Useless pissant.
Wow.
Like how the accent just comes and goes.
Yeah.
I'm 112 years old.
Question 4. Complete this analogy. Exonym is to endonym as Spain is to blank.
Nothing about this quiz has made sense.
Locked in.
Locked in?
Locked in?
Yeah, I'm locked in.
Good night, Mr. Walters.
Okay, let's start with Deva.
Andorra.
Okay. Kels?
España.
Twy?
España.
Andy?
Spanish. Don't you laugh. Don't you laugh.
I didn't laugh. That's all Kels.
I only laugh because I heard somebody giggle.
So an exonym is the name of a country as known by foreigners. Oh. An endonym is the name locals have for their own countries.
Oh. Very cool.
So, for example, Germany would be Deutschland, Italy, Italia, and Spain, España.
Oh. Wow.
I had no idea. Very cool.
At the end of Category 5, Devo and Andy have 122 points.
Hey.
Twy has 152 and Kells has 157. It's anybody's game.
I got room to kneecap him. Okay.
Wow. Wow. Gloves are off.
Question
You're
1.
Nancy, I'm telling you.
What?
The why thing. Good Lord, that was spot on. Wow. I haven't seen the news clip in a million years, but there it is.
How did they think they were going to get away with that?
I don't know.
That was so crazy. Jeff Galooly, is that his name?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Jeff Galooly.
The category is hodgepodge / potpourri.
Even better. Yeah.
Question 1. El Nino, that Pacific Ocean weather phenomenon with the little squiggly over the second N, is Spanish for the boy child. What boy child is El Nino named after? And she has possibly a very easy mode.
I'll take it.
I want to take the bait.
Easy mode.
In fact, there's actually a super easy mode too if we want to go there.
I'll take that too.
Me well, too.
Let's start with the easy mode first.
Can I uneasy mode?
Always.
Okay, I'm uneasy moding.
Locked in.
Okay. So Andy and Twy are locked in. Kells and Dewa want the easy mode. The easy mode is no bonus points, but if you, but you'll get a comedy attaboy for saying it in the style of Ricky Bobby.
Oh, I almost said it. All right, I locked in. I almost said it out of frustration.
I'll take super easy mode.
Okay, so super easy mode. We don't usually do this, so I'll give you 2 points for the super easy mode.
Cool.
It became known as El Nino because of its tendency to occur around Christmas time.
Oh.
I mean, it really can't get much easier than that, I don't think.
Right.
No.
I could still get it wrong.
You could.
Stavo. It's referring to the different strokes.
Right.
Holiday special. The boy child. Right. The boy child.
Willis.
Is indeed.
Willis. I'm locked in with my
Gary
with my
Coleman. Answer.
It was Gary Coleman.
Kels.
I like the Christmas Jesus the best, you hear me?
Twy.
The Christ child.
Andy.
Baby Jesus.
And Devo.
Baby Jesus.
It is Jesus. Question two. Inspired by her work with terminally ill patients, what Swiss-American psychiatrist introduced the five stages of grief in her 1969 book on death and dying? And for a bonus, what was Allison's mnemonic for the five stages? Because if you remember, we had this.
Yeah.
Ooh, we're missing one thing, and I've got bingo. Come on, Andy, it's on you.
I think I know what it is. I'm locked in.
Okay, is everybody locked in?
Yes.
Yes, mm-hmm. Locked in.
Yeah. Let's start with Kells.
Kubler-Ross.
Oh.
Nabda. Like D-A-B-D-A.
Oh, okay. That's why.
Kubler-Ross, and I don't know the mnemonic.
Andy.
I couldn't come up with the name, but I remember the mnemonic, Dabda. Mnemonic.
Dabba Dabba.
Just move it right on. Dave.
Kubler-Ross, and I didn't remember the mnemonic.
Okay. Well, it was Elizabeth Kubler-Ross. Oh, can anybody spell it? Because she said she'd get if anybody who could actually spell her last name an extra bonus point.
K-U with the umlaut.
B-L-E-R-R-O-S-S.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you all specifically, well, three of you specifically got the umlaut, which is what she was looking for. So
okay.
There's one extra point for each of you.
Woohoo.
So yes, it is Elizabeth Kubler-Ross, and denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance equals Dabda. All right. Question three. Odds, as in gambling, are expressed as ratios. Here's a story problem for you.
Oh, boy. Love those.
Andy and Dava walk into a casino in downtown Las Vegas and find a roulette table. One of them bets on black and the other bets on red. What are the true odds that both of them will lose?
The true odds.
Ooh.
That both of us will lose?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, I want to make sure I got the right game. Is that the wheel thingy where they drop the ball in this?
Yes.
Wow, okay.
I don't
nobody's karate, nobody's karate chopping you. You're safe.
Unless she's faking it.
Ooh, she's faking it.
All right, so...
I'm just guessing. In. I'm locked in. I don't know why I'm even bothering.
Man, Dave, I feel so bad. You sound like you're somebody kicked your puppy or something.
Well, you know,
it happens every once in a while.
But you're really tired from the kids, right?
I'm sure.
Locked in?
I'm locked in.
Let's start with Andy.
All right. So I know that there are red and black, and there's also two green slots, right? So I have down 1 out of 18.
Okay. Deva.
50:1.
Okay. Kels.
I said 1 in 19 chance.
And Twy.
2 in 20 chances.
One of you got it right. So there are 18 red spaces, 18 black spaces, and 2 green spaces, which makes the odds of the true odds being 2 to 38, or simplified to 1 in 19.
Yes.
Very good job.
Seriously, I'm off by 1.
Don't yell at me.
I'm yelling at the universe. This game is breaking us. What is happening?
I mean, you're all doing
when pretty... we started this match 19 hours ago, we were all laughing and having fun.
I don't know. I mean, the scores are actually pretty decent.
Uh-huh. If you're in first or second.
Well. I mean, everybody broke the Allison line after the halfway point.
Yep.
Well, that's, I mean, after good. Category 4.
It's something.
I'll take it.
Final question. Okay. So this is kind of a special rule for this one. If you haven't activated your parenthetical, here's your last chance. True or false? Oh, shoot. I forgot she had this special rule. I totally forgot all about it. So she wanted to play this with the rule that you could answer any question with a parenthetical and opt to use your parenthetical as a possible answer. So basically, you could give two answers.
Oh. So I would have gotten mine right at the very beginning when I said spaces. Damn it.
Yeah, but I forgot to say it. So I'm going to give you that option now. Okay, for this final question. Okay. Again, the question is, if you haven't activated your parenthetical special rule, here's your last chance. True or false? There is a variation of the percentage sign that indicates a number is divided by 1,000 instead of 100.
Variation.
I'm locked in.
Oh, you're saying, it's true or false.
And you can do a parenthetical.
You can do a parenthetical.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. I feel so bad. She's going to listen to this and say, he didn't mention the parenthetical rule, and she's going to get to hear, and she's going to be mad at me. I'm sorry, Gina. It was my bad. Let's start with Devo.
False, but my parenthetical is true.
Okay. I see what you did there. Kels.
I said the same thing. False, but my parenthetical is true.
Okay. Twy.
I said true, but my parenthetical is false.
Andy.
I would like to karate chop Kels.
So, you could have easily got points, but you'd rather me not have
money. Right.
Okay.
Take that.
This will always be a great mystery in the history of Brain Ladle as to what happened in the recording session with Devo. Or it's just Neil, Devo, and a microphone. And somehow Neil coaxed Devo to...
I don't think it was much coaxing involved.
They're a very not Devo, and it's just
he had some of those lined up before he showed up to the studio.
No, Devo didn't. Did you know what we were gonna do before?
I didn't.
He did those all on the fly. Wow. I was gonna have him just do one general one. And then as we discussed it, I don't know who came up with the idea. We decided to do one for each of them. And then he just channeled each of you.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
He gets all the credit.
Wow. Well, amazing job.
Thank you.
All right. Well, so two of you, well, you all got it right, sort of. Twy was technically more correct than the rest of you. Oh. There is a symbol. It's like a percent sign, but the bottom part of the percent has an extra zero.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Well, that's kind of neat.
Well, actually,
kind of makes sense.
Yeah, three zeros. Oh, yeah, there's one with two zeros and there's another one with three zeros. I don't know if it keeps going after that. But what that means is our final scores before sudden death are Devo with 145.
Wow.
Andy, 147. Twy, 183. And Kells, 188.
Interesting. Man.
Sudden death.
Exclamation mark.
So for the listeners, I asked each of the players to do something a little unusual before we started this episode, which was to bring a towel or something similar with them. So right now I'm going to ask all the players to close their eyes. Okay. I can't see you, so I'm trusting that you do it.
Okay.
Take your towel and place it over your keyboard so that you cannot see any of the keys.
Oh, I can't see any of my keys anyway.
Wait, hold on.
My keyboard's in a drawer.
Well, I want to make sure. I didn't know where everybody's keyboard was. I just want to make sure nobody can see their keyboard.
I'm putting it on the keyboard in the drawer anyway. Just to be completely honest.
Okay, keyboard's covered.
Okay, so you can open your eyes now once you've done that. So this is going to be a really quick sudden death for me. I just need to know. You can go ahead and write all your answers down if you want. I need to know what from 1 to 0 for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0. I need to know what the punctuation for each of those keyboard keys is. So you can go ahead and write down your answers and we'll go through them one at a time and still play with the sudden death rules.
Wait.
I don't know what's on one, so I'm boned.
So being a computer programmer, I use a lot of these symbols all the time. So I could fake this one. I don't have them memorized, but I know how I would type for each of these characters.
Yeah, I'm typing.
I'm typing on my blotter right now.
Yeah.
I'm locked in with what I got. I am stymied.
I'm locked in as well.
Okay. So we'll start with Kells. What is above the number one?
The exclamation point.
Deva?
I put a period.
Okay. Andy?
Exclamation point.
And Twy?
Exclamation point.
The correct answer is an exclamation point. I'm sorry, Devo, you are out.
Mm-hmm.
Question. So number two, Andy?
The at symbol.
Twy?
The at symbol.
Kells?
The at symbol.
That is correct. Twy, number three.
Hashtag, pound sign, whatever the kids call it now.
Hashtag.
Octothorpe, come on.
Oh yeah, I forgot it was the Octothorpe.
Kels.
The tic tac toe board.
Oh come on.
Pound sign.
Andy. Octothorpe. I have the pound sign.
Okay, that is correct. Four Kels.
Dollar sign.
Dollar bills, y'all.
Even when he makes a joke, it sounds sad. It was the saddest joke ever. Familiar
faces, long faces. Yo, I could see his like his audio bar, and it's not moving. He's not even laughing with us.
No, he's just
no. We broke Davo.
Broke Davo.
Andy.
What number are we on?
Four.
Four, the dollar sign.
And Twy.
Dollar sign.
It's dollar sign. Number five, Andy.
Percentage.
Twy.
Percentage.
And Kels.
Percentage.
That is correct. Number six, Twy.
The up arrow, the... Yeah. The thingy.
Kels.
Carrot symbol.
Andy.
This is where I was out. I couldn't come up with anything after five.
The correct answer is the carrot. Or the up arrow. Or the thingy.
You knew what I meant.
I did. Okay, we're down to Twy and Kels. Let's go to number seven, Kels.
Ampersand.
And Twy?
Ampersand.
That is correct. Number eight, Twy.
The asterisk.
Kels.
Asterisk.
That is correct. Number nine, Kels.
Open parentheses.
Twy.
Open parentheses.
And Twy, number 10.
Close parentheses.
Or I should say zero. Kels?
Close parentheses.
You both swept it.
Man.
You're saying you both type a lot, huh?
That's I was nervous with six and seven. All I was day. Like, I'm going to get those backwards.
That's very impressive.
I don't think we've ever had two sweeps.
Nope. Never had a double sweep.
Good
very
job.
Very cool.
So what that means is... we have our final scores. Devo with 145. Andy, 197. Twy, 283. And Kels, whoa. 288.
Wow.
Wow.
Fantastic job, guys.
Well done. Kels and Twy, thanks for letting me and Devo hang out with you. This has made me feel so much dumber than I did a few hours ago.
I hear that. So where does that leave us in the tournament?
So tournament wise, Davo has eight.
The funeral episode, Davo. Trying to just
thank you.
The saddest MC of them all.
Davo has 8, Andy 10, Twy 13, and Kels a mere 19.
Mere.
No.
Very good job. Very impressive, Kels. Good
thank
job.
Thank you.
So, from all of us here at the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast, this is your MC Davo with Kels.
Beer. 8 pound, 6 ounce, newborn infant Jesus. Don't even know a word yet, but it's so tiny and omnipotent.
Twy.
Andy, I'm disappointed because you didn't make a Beatles reference. I didn't get bingo.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And Andy.
I do so wish this terrible tournament was over. Signed, Mary Chestnut. P.S. So long, little brainers.
And the Sensei Neil.
So I found this song from Dan Baird. Does anybody know who that is?
No. Nope.
Lead singer for the Georgia Satellites.
Oh.
That's pretty good. Signing off.
Greetings. This is the Brain Ladle Lyric Bot 5000. You can reach us on Twitter at LadleBrain, on Facebook at Brain Ladle Productions, or on our website at BrainLadleTrivia.com. You can join us on Patreon, where a $10 donation will get you a show invite. I like big butts and I cannot lie.
What is that little white dot supposed to be over LB5K's left eye?
I don't know. Just
is it like a teardrop tat?
He's a ruthless son of a bitch.
Yeah, he killed a guy in prison.
He's a ruthless son of a bitch.
Yeah. Dear God, what is that?
Yeah. It's like a...
I think it's supposed to be a reflection on the screen.
Maybe. Or a birthmark.
You know, there is nothing holding those front and back rollers on him at all.
I mentioned that. They're just fucking floating there. Oh, hang on. We're just about to start. Oh, shit, I didn't load those. Hang on.
Just about ready to start high karate.
I gotta do it right.
And it's H-A-I, not H-I karate.
Because it's racist as all get out. It was the 1960s.
They go for the full offensive.
Yeah. This product was offensive to women as well as Asians, as well as to people with a sense of smell.
The high karate prize, which Kells is on track to get, is right at your house.
Yep.
So it
is in the garage with the rest of the chemicals.
Have you been before school? You've been running down there putting a little dab.
I just love the idea, you know, all of us, Kells is a swinging bachelor. And, you know, I love the idea that Kells is finally going to meet Mrs. Wright and she's going to be over at his house. She's going to be in the bathroom like, this dude's got high karate. What the hell?
But then she's going to sniff.
I thought he was the one.
No, I saw the commercial. She's going to sniff it, and then he's going to beat her. He's going to have to beat her off with a stick.
Right. Yeah, she's going to be getting over him. Do you have a stick?
I mean, the dude in the commercial didn't really stand a chance. Right. He got thrown over the couch. I'm not small. Like,
no.
You're a muscular, fine hunk of man. It's going to take a profound effort from this. From
interesting description.
Is it wrong?
I feel like,
tell me I'm wrong.
I feel like we might well. You're not
tell
wrong.
Tell me what I'm telling lies.
No, you're not wrong. You're... I can't see him, but I presume out of all of us, he's the only one wearing a shirt right now that does not have food stains down the front.
No, I changed my shirt this afternoon.
Wait a minute, what is that? Ah, oh, damn it.
Yeah. I know.
One food stain.
Food stains, plural. Not necessarily all from today.
The preceding podcast was presented by Brain Ladle Productions. All rights reserved.
Sure, come get this baby.